with the Minister of Finance and Economic Development, Professor Mtulingube.
You know what? We've always had a domestic currency and also use the US dollar and multiple currencies in the multi-currency regime. So we need a domestic currency. Why? Because we cannot run monetary policy with a hard foreign currency. You can't do that. You can't print, you can't use interest rate policy to impact demand for the currency. So you always need a domestic currency to push economic growth forward and to drive development. So we're in transition. This is in transition. This $75 is nothing other than an inflation protector for civil servants. But also we did a 50% salary increase in Zimbabwe dollar terms. So both were done, and all of this is designed to cushion civil servants. And it's not final. This is only the beginning. This is an offer from the president. It's an offer from the employer to civil servants to say, we understand your plight. Here is something. While we conclude negotiations, negotiations on the normal salary increase are ongoing. This one is just the beginning, and it's an offer from the employer and from the president.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much.
Are you happy with the bidding system?
Oh, I was very happy indeed that the auction system was very successful on its first day. We received, obviously, several bids, ranging from 25 to all the way to 100. We only allocated from 35 to 100, 10.3 million US dollars. And we hope that, there'll be more participation in future. And this should help, I think, stabilize the exchange rate, at least unify the exchange rate and improve price discovery for our currency, give better value for our currency. Also good for the tobacco farmers, who will now be able to get a more favorable exchange rate for their US dollars in terms of the retention. It's also good for the gold producers as well, who also get a favorable rate for their US dollars in terms of what they retain out of what Fidelity pays them.
Do you anticipate any saboteurs to already be planning to perhaps?
Oh yes, the saboteurs are always lurking around the corner, I'm afraid. The speculators, people going to money laundering and all manner of shenanigans and speculators. So they are always there. They are looking for loopholes. But look, we'll enforce the law. We'll go after them. Not hesitate to deal with them. We now have an official process to determine the value for currency. Let's all embrace it, let's all support it, and the detractors to stand back and toe the line.
Secretary, Comrade Patrick Kinamasa.
Good afternoon, Zimbabwe. We are coming to you live from the National Hero Circle, where the occasion has been the burial of the late war commander, Comrade Stanley Nhleya. He has been buried at the National Shrines, a befitting, of course, honor to the wartime commander, Comrade Nhleya. We are joined here by my senior colleague in the party, Comrade Patrick Anton Chinamasa, the acting spokesperson of the party. Comrade Chinamasa, let's talk and probably give Zimbabweans one or two clues about Comrade Nhleya. Here is a gallant son who has been laid here. Now, the legacy of Comrade Nhleya.
The legacy of Comrade Nhleya is that he gave long, selfless service to the liberation of our country. As His Excellency said in his speech, he joined the liberation struggle in 1968 and remained faithful to the liberation, to the struggle until independence. After independence, he demonstrated that he was a humble cadre and remained loyal to the party until his untimely death. So we treasure the memory of Comrade Nhleya. Mm-hmm. We treasure his contribution to the liberation struggle. We treasure his unity, his dedication to the unity of the people of Zimbabwe. Mm-hmm. And these are the legacies that we are going to continuously cherish as
now,
we go
social
forward.
Social media corporate spokesperson has been on the high drive to split and divide our people. Those characters that have been on overdrive on Twitter, social media, Facebook, maligning the heroes. And some have even gone to the extent What is your take on those statements, especially in the light of gallant sacrifices like those done by Comrade Nhleya?
Yes, what the people of Zimbabwe should know is that the enemy, the devil, is always busier than them. While they are sleeping, the devil is not sleeping. Mm-hmm. There are a lot of forces that have been ranged against the people of Zimbabwe, against ZANU-PF, and the Zimbabweans have remained loyal, faithful, patriotic, and they should forever remain so. They should ignore completely the negative forces that are emanating on social media. Those forces are those which, since we embarked on the land reform program, have been predicting our fall every day, have been telling us we are dead. We have died so many times, but through these many deaths, both of our gallant soldiers, we are going to triumph, and the people of Zimbabwe must know that Zimbabwe will never be a colony again.
We are sitting.
No matter what the negative forces may say, the people of Zimbabwe will not allow this country to revert to the dark forces of yesterday.
Now the enemy appear to have come up with a different strategy altogether. You are aware of that young doctor called Magombe who sneaked out of the country with the assistance of one particular embassy after engaging in some skit. And then the same challenge appeared to be recurring itself in light of the three activists from the other faction of the MDC. Are we going to remain strong and outmaneuver these new strategies that the enemy is employing against us?
Yes, what you must know is what is important is that the truth must prevail. But what you must know is that the truth is like a tortoise. Falsehoods are like the rabbit. They go faster, but at the end of the day, the tortoise will overtake. The truth will prevail. And the truth of the matter is that all those so-called abductions are masterminded, stage managed, and basically to try to throw bad reputation on ZANU-PF. So the people who get to know the truth, and the truth is also emerging. For instance, there have been falsehoods saying the president, by being photographed with people who may turn out to be criminals, was himself a criminal. Those are falsehoods which cannot stand the test of time, which cannot stand the test of truth. So what is important is that the truth will prevail.
And some of those culprits that have turned to become criminals, were actually had an opportunity to have those photos taken with them with leadership during the donations of COVID-19. Can we certainly then say, the president should not have accepted those donations when he didn't know the profile of those people, except he was received?
Given the circumstances of fighting this invisible enemy, the government is right to accept donations from anybody. And also those who give donations have a right to be appreciated. That does not mean that the president is associated with their businesses. It does not. And this is what we have refuted and will continue to refute. The fact that a president is photographed by donors does not mean that he's an owner of those businesses. No, that must be made clear. And I think that over time, the truth will prevail.
Thank you very much, Comrade Spokesperson. Now, just to give Zimbabweans a word as we go towards the 2023, just tell us what we are going to do with them as ZANU-PF and President Emmerson Mnangagwa.
Yes, you know we have a track record. ZANU-PF has a track record. ZANU-PF has a history, a history of liberation, a history of transformation. And the people of Zimbabwe know our DNA.
Yes.
That we are for the people, we work for the people, and as we go forward, the people will understand that it's only ZANU-PF which works for the people. We are not like other political parties who go out to ask for sanctions against their own people, who go out to hobnob with the enemy in other foreign capitals. ZANU-PF has stood the test of time. And come 2023, the people will support their party. They will know who is their biggest defender. They will know.
I had just forgotten this question, but it's a very critical one. Just recently, when the World Bank and IMF were about to release nearly 7 million or 700 million, I'm not quite sure about the figure, but to Zimbabwe in COVID relief, which other countries have gotten. You are aware that in a bit, you know, one of the MDC faction leaders wrote a statement, a letter to them, telling them to stop giving Zimbabwe that money.
Yes, we are aware, but clearly I was not surprised by BT. BT's political career, he has invested heavily mm-hmm. in linking himself to the Republicans mm-hmm. in the United States. Mm-hmm. He is one of those who is revered mm-hmm. by the intelligence services of the United States. Mm-hmm. So he is not doing his own bidding. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. He is basically being used by those forces mm-hmm. who wanted to undermine the sovereignty of this country mm-hmm. in order to advance their interests. Not even BT's interests. Mm-hmm. BT's mm-hmm. interests cannot be advanced by making people denied yes. of help from the World Bank, from the IMF. Mm-hmm. They are not advanced. Yes. I can't understand how they can be advanced. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. The interests which are being advanced are the interests of those countries which impose sanctions against Zimbabwe mm-hmm. and who have not forgiven us mm-hmm. for embarking on the land reform program.
Ah, thank you very much, Comrade Spokesperson. Thank you. It was a good chat. Thank you.